have an unspoken request, show forth by the lifting of your hands. God is wonderful this morning. Let us just bow our hearts before Him this morning. Lord, we thank you, Lord. We appreciate you, Lord. We appreciate everything you have done for us, Lord. Lord, we not deserve it, Lord God, but you so merciful, Lord, rich in mercy, Lord. You just so good to us, oh God. Lord, you just give us inspiration to put on our clothes and come to church and worship with one another, Lord. Lord God, I know you're going to bless us, oh God. Because you said, neglect not to assemble yourself together as you see that day approaching, oh God. And we're in that day, oh God, the evil day, oh God. Lord, with all the spirits are pressing against us, oh God. But yet, Lord, you rich in mercy, Lord, allowed us once again, Lord, to come into your house of prayer, oh God, that we can seek refuge, oh God. Lord God, we know you in the wings of the Almighty, oh God, under your shadow, oh God. Lord, may you reign down your sweet Holy Spirit, oh God. Open up our hearts, Lord. Pour us out blessings we have not room to receive, oh God. Help us to get a new revelation today, oh God. Lord, as we reminded on Friday night, Lord, how the revelation means more to us than we can imagine, oh God. Lord God, it's nothing in us, Lord. You clothe us with your righteousness, oh God. And we're so thankful, Lord. We are a thankful people, Lord. Lord God, we are needy people, oh God. We need help from you every day, oh God. Lord, bless those that are still pressing their way out, Lord. And Lord, do something new in our lives this morning, oh God. Lord, bless the ministry as it comes forth. Bless every song, Lord, that's on people's hearts, oh God. Let them not sing to be seen or heard, but let them sing to you, Jesus. Lord, that you bless your people, oh God. Lord God, may every act of worship this morning be not done in vain, oh God. But let us reverence your house, oh God. Somebody got a need this morning. Somebody got a headache, Lord. Need to be removed this morning. Lord, somebody got stomach trouble. Lord God, need to be removed this morning. Lord, somebody got a financial burden, Lord. Need to be removed this morning, oh God. But we know you as a high priest, oh God. Lord, can be touched by the feelings of our infirmities, Lord. Lord, we come to get help this morning. Oh God, we know that if we come to get help, Lord, it's a God to help us, oh God. Lord, we thank you, Lord, this morning. Lord, we ask, Lord, that you save somebody this morning, oh God. Let them know that your saving power is still in effect, oh God. Oh God, we remind you, Lord God, that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever, Lord. Lord, if you save somebody else, Lord, if we meet them on the same grounds, Lord, you do the exact same thing again, oh God. Help us to be mindful of that, oh God. Lord, strengthen our pastor, oh God. Oh God, how he labor for us, oh God. No doubt he has to fight all these spirits that trouble us, oh God. Oh God, all of them, the burden bearer, oh God. Strengthen them this morning, oh God. Oh God, that's our little shepherd, oh God, that you're giving us, oh God. Lord, bless the remainder of the services, oh God. And bless the bride all around the world, the fivefold ministry, Brother Buzz, Brother Mike, their ministries. Special blessings to Brother Jew, Lord, as he go out, Lord. He blessed us. Lord, we just appreciate everything you've done for us, Lord. You love us, Lord, because you show it every day, oh God. Lord, we give you praise and honor and glory in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We pray. May the church say amen.
Let God people say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
He's worthy of it, isn't he? Come on, come and clap our hands for the Lord. Jesus. I'm pretty praise. Well, there's a storm out. Oh, life's so shine. And you prove it. I ain't gonna soldier. Hallelujah. I'm God's soldier. And I'm in an invincible army. But this army came to me. Give God some praise for it. God bless you. Hallelujah. You can be seated for a moment. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. It's good to see all of God's people this morning. So I believe he lives among his people. I'm a soldier. And not just any army, but the army. The army that has never lost a battle. Yeah. And I appreciate this morning. God bless you. Amen. Sister Gill is going to come and bless you this morning. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah. How many is on a great expectation this morning? Yeah. You know, you're only going to get what you come looking for now. So come with great expectations. Y'all pray. Thank you.
Roma.
Could not be hit, John saw, has it equal.
Thank you. 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 That's why we're in church this morning. Amen. To walk those streets of gold. Amen. Let's give God some praise this morning. Amen. As the brothers come, we have an offering. God bless you.
Father, we thank you, Lord God, for your grace and your mercy, Father. Lord, we know, Lord, that you are here, Father. Lord, we can feel, Lord, your presence, Lord, all over the building, Father. Lord, and while you're here, Lord God, we just thank you, Father, that you would just, Lord, cleanse our hearts, Father. Lord, that the word, Lord, prepares to come forth, Lord God. Father, help our hearts, Lord, to be prepared to receive it, Lord God. Father, take Brother Mullins, Lord. Lord, move him so completely out of the way, Lord God, so he can't even find his own self, Lord God. Father, you speak to this congregation today, Father. Lord, and take this offering, Lord God. Father, you've seen, Lord, you've blessed so many times, Lord God. Father, you're still the same yesterday, today, and forever, Lord God. Father, so we know you're blessed again, Father. Lord, we just thank, Father, that you'll bless those that have, Lord. Father, those that have the very desire, Lord, to give, Lord God. Father, bless the people, Lord God, and bless this offering, Father. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Let the church say amen.
God bless you.
One day. Yes, sir.
a little bit of reading to do, so I'm going to skip a whole lot of it. Revelation 19:7. Amen. Now listen to me. I want everybody to give the Holy Spirit your unabided attention this morning. Give him your attention this morning. Amen. Now listen now. Who this pastor script here is talking to now? In Revelation 19:7, the Bible says, let us be glad and rejoice and give honor to him, for the marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife has made herself ready.
Brothers, bow their heads in prayer. Most gracious and everlasting God, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Father, what an hour we're living in, Lord. The closing hour, Lord, of time itself, Lord, has run out, Lord. And Father, here, Lord, we are here this morning, Lord, on the mercy and grace, Lord, and on the basis, Lord, of the revelation, Lord, that in this hour, Lord, that you have given to each and every one of us, Lord. Father, we're reminded, Lord, down through the ages, Lord, you give each and every one of your messages, Lord, a gift in the Holy Spirit, Lord. You have enlightened them, Lord, with so much revelation, Lord, in that age that they're living in. But Father, we're living, Lord, in the hour, Lord, where all the revelation, where all the word will be and made known, Lord. We are here, Lord, on the basis, Lord, of revelation itself, Lord. You call us, Lord, by revelation, Lord. You made us, Lord, by your spoken word. Lord, we are here, Lord, because you chose us, Lord. And this morning, Lord, may the Holy Spirit, Lord, will take complete control, Lord, of God's provided place of worship this morning, Lord. And the devil's need here, Lord, there's a Holy Ghost here, Lord, that grant every present need here this morning, Lord. We won't right now, Lord, Jesus, God, on the sound, Lord, and on the quietness, Lord, of each and every one of them voice, Lord, and my voice, Lord. May the Holy Spirit, Lord, with silence, Lord, every spirit, Lord, that's not like yours, Lord. May the people, Lord, God, to receive some, Lord, to give them strength, Lord, to get them ready, Lord, to get them out of here, Lord. May, Lord, those that, Lord, that don't have the baptism of the Holy Ghost, Lord, may God this morning, Lord, you would deal with them, Lord, on hidden, Lord. May everyone here this morning, Lord, will receive you this morning, Lord. For we pray and ask in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, you be saved.
Amen. Amen. I'm going to start out this morning. Amen. Dearly beloved. And everybody here probably, no doubt they never had a wedding, probably heard those words before, when the bride and groom come before the marriage. And the first thing you do, here, yeah, no doubt to stand up when the bride presents herself. Is that right? Right. And when the groom, he's already standing in the chamber because he's waiting on something very important to happen. Amen. Amen. And then the preacher gets up, then he says, dearly beloved, we are just here today to witness the union. Amen. The union of this man and this woman. Amen.
going to this woman. I did not, he said, in the marriage ceremony, the church on with for better or worse. Sickness, poverty, it don't make no difference. I'm willing to be with you.
Right.
Is that right? I'm willing to take on your name. Whether it be the cold sweeper, I'm willing to take on your name.
Yes, Lord.
Regardless of whatever the present state that he's in, you promised that you would take his name.
Right.
Is that right? Now, here's Jesus Christ. He gonna die.
Right.
Let me break it down. The mighty angel come himself.
Right. Right.
With a mess.
Yes, sir.
Did y'all hear me?
Come on, you're hot. We're gonna change you. We're gonna change you.
say nothing of good man when you look for his wife. Let's go back to Calvary. The Father knew his whole plan. So he sent his son, Christ, to die for our sin. Huh? Did you hear me? All God was, he emptied in Christ. All Christ was, he emptied himself into his bride. The church. Is that correct? Now listen here. All that he was, we are.
Amen. Amen.
Is that right? I'm going to say that again. All that he was, we are.
Amen.
Is that right? So we are just not just anybody. According to the message, we are a special class of people.
Yes.
I want that to sink in.
Yes.
I said we are a special class of people. Yes. Not just any kind of people, but a special class.
Yes.
I didn't make that up.
It's there.
The Bible didn't make that up. But guess what? He himself said it.
Come on, sir.
Did y'all hear it? still matter.
That's right.
He still matter. He still matter.
Yeah. Huh? Yeah.
By the way, you still matter.
Yes, sir.
You were the one.
Yes, sir.
You remember when he married in force, I think that page, he told Brother Bradley, because you had chosen just
the hard way.
You chose to say. It was your choice.
My choice.
Right. Now listen to me, Brother Ray. When he came your way, when he knocked on your door,
yes, sir.
Amen, it was up to you to
open it.
If you were on a free ride, yes. You could have turned this message down and walked away.
Oh, glory! Come on, sir.
You could have walked away.
Yes, sir.
Everybody can walk away.
Yes, sir.
And he'll never deal with you no more.
My God.
But because you told us to say. And he said, no, she said, I still love you.
Oh, glory.
He said, I still love you. Love will take the place,
yes, sir,
of a lot of things.
Yes, sir.
Love, Brother Brown said that love is the most powerful force there is.
Yes, sir.
So you be careful when you tell little girls and little boys that you love.
Oh, yeah.
You be careful with them. Because you can hurt them,
yes, sir,
or break them.
Atoning blood for every sin, every mistake that you make.
happened when a lot of us were trapped in things. I said a lot of us were trapped in things. But God, who is rich in mercy, told faith that you trapped them. But I'm going to bring them out with a strong hand of faith. I'm going to pull them out. Revelation 18 and 4 declares, he said, come out of there, my people.
Yes, sir.
Come out of those denomination systems.
Yes.
For they rotten to the core.
And will forsake all others and cleave thee only unto her as long as you both live.
Amen.
When you take this man to be your lawful wedded husband, to live together.
Hold up, baby. Excuse me, my precious brothers and sisters. But y'all have heard the vows this morning.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to ask each and every one of you individually, if you would, you heard the marriage vows. And it's up to you this morning to give your opinion on what has already been read. But the question was, will you take this man?
Yes.
Now this man is Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Now listen to me. I'm going to take your blood from off my hand and put it back in your hand.
Yes,
I'm going to preach it, then I'm going to let it be up to you.
Yes.
Is that all right?
Yes.
Is that all right, my precious brother and sister? Now y'all hear what he said. My precious brothers and sisters this morning. It's up to you, my precious sisters this morning. With all due respect, y'all heard the reading of the vows, but it's up to you. Now you have a choice.
Right.
Now you have a choice this morning.
Yes.
To walk out here this morning and you ain't got nothing. You can go on in the world and do anything with you want, and they'll meet you on that day of judgment. The message of the hour will meet you and it will condemn you.
Yes.
But this morning, will you take this man, Jesus, to be your
lawful wedded husband?
Yes.
To live together.
Hold on, I'm going to step off the scene for a minute. Now here he is right here, his cousin is here. Read that again, I want everybody to hear that. Read it slow.
Will you take this man?
Listen what he said. He said, will you? He didn't say young or old. He didn't say nothing about age, bracket, and age.
Right.
He said, will you individually, person, take this man
to be your lawful wedded husband?
Will you do that?
Yes.
Can anybody testify to that? Will you do that? If everybody in here are willing to do that, can I put y'all on the spot? I'm going to do it.
Yeah.
Raise your hand.
Watch out for
it, right? There won't be no way today. But instead, Huh? I ain't gonna scare you if you show. Huh? What about you depending on her check and your check? If she tell you, time to go. I'm out of here. I ain't going this morning. Go ahead, man. Don't miss me. Go ahead. Come on. Wait up about 5 more minutes to get to work. You better try to get there. And then she got holding scriptures and a man. He told me to stay home. He told me to not pay for this. Did you know she paid on the script they had to get this? Did you know she ain't got the movie she don't want to move? She just doing that because of the Bible. And I can do what I want with. I said, oh, sister. You know what she said?
Why?
I tell you what, man, let's go to Brother Gibbs. Wait. So you know what I did? I said, I'll tell you what you do then, sister. You let me pay all the bills.
Why did what?
Let me pay all the bills. But if you make one, not yours. Huh? Send me, brother. Make home now.
She made haste to get ready, go back and get.
kids, brother, sister. When she had a few days, just a few days, brother, sister, that the communion had fellowship with her mom and dad and her brother, they didn't want to go. But guess what she did? She knows what the time here is. She knows that her time has arrived. She knows that there was somebody she never seen before was waiting on. Huh? And the same meal of donkey that she was, Brother Trey, is the one that packed her home.
Yes, sir.
The one that packed her home. And if you go back and read that seal book, Brother Sister, about the little girl, the little old girl, hold that off, the little old girl. And this girl comes from Chicago looking for him a box. Huh? I mean, all along they was all duty up, looking good, all painted up, as they can say. I mean, the rules, everything. I mean, they had enough lipstick on, enough. They already had over the best trade. Now they got these big old claw nails. They call that them claw nails back then. I mean, they was ready. The only thing they were trying to do is impress him. Huh? After he spent a little time in there with him and all that stuff, he got tired. He got tired of looking at all that mess. So I'm going to give me some fresh air. And when he walked out, Brother Grant, little did he know there was a little wash girl. Little wash girl just got me washing dishes, no doubt she's probably up here. And throw the water out, and the conversation started. A decent conversation started. Did you hear me? A good, healthy, decent conversation started. Huh? Did y'all hear me, little people? Let me tell you something. Let me say this here. If you talk with your friends and they got a good, decent, Holy Ghost conversation, a good conversation, you having fellowship with the wrong person. Change your company. Change your surroundings. Which I can't do. Don't let the devil fool you what you cannot do. You can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens you. A vacuum cleaner. Obviously, she didn't mind doing it. She did it. Huh? Washed the dishes. Your mother wasn't fussing about it. She did it. Huh? I mean, back then, she probably went there. A lot of us would call it. She probably was a foot washing monkey for them. Everything they take off, she had to pick it up and clean up the house, stuff like that, because she's a woman. They use her and they use her. Huh? But God had a plan for her. Read that, brother.
Yes, sir.
But you know what he did? He paused. we made her a promise, Brother Rex, to look here, to stay true to your vow. To stay true to your vow. I'm coming back for you. He's going to give you this much time out here to make ready. Say, go ahead and get yourself ready. Save the little pennies. What are you going to do? But guess what? I'm going with you. I'm going to build you a home. I'm going to build you a home that you ain't never got to clean up no more. You'll have somebody else clean up your own house. You ain't got that to worry about no more. You won't have to worry about the terror and the horror of this life no more. You won't have to worry about the aches and the pain nowhere. He said, oh, no, Brother Gibbs, he done gone away to prepare a place for you. And where I am, there he will be also. He said, go, the great architect has said, that already built his praise passion to you that I thought, that I think will fit you. I know what you lack, brother. Huh? And they told us, look, girl, you must be had a bad dream. You must be in a strong delusion. What make you think this man coming back to get you? That was those denominations talk. What make you all that you think that he gonna, you?
Yes.
So you don't even have a decent pair of shoes. You don't even dress the dress code like we do. You ain't been nowhere. You ain't been to the court parties. You ain't been to no party. You don't know what to tell him. You know what she said, Brother Gil? Be prompt.
Be prompt.
Oh my God.
Be prompt. Well, the first time she ever stuck her chest out. Be prompt. And I believe it. Time went on. Time went on. And all the time when time is going on, Brother Sight, you know what she do? She's making ready. She's getting ready. She's probably cleaning up that big house of death for the last time. So from now on, y'all gonna have to get somebody else to clean up behind me. Cause I'm doing this job here. Huh? And all at the same time, Brother, she's getting the time. And he's promised to get me out that time. She stepped out the door, and when she stepped out the door, she said, where you going? It's about time. For my husband.
All right.
About time for my man to come get me. Yeah. And when she did, brother, she stepped out, they stepped out, picked it up. They probably had a running revival on them. Yeah. They're about ready to call the psychiatrist. They're about ready to do everything negative to them. But a distance down the road, they look up and they see your life. When you were really, it was love at first sight.
First sight.
Wait a minute. You mean to tell me, what about all the rest of the girls? All the rest of the girls just play. Play. That's what we're going to call it. Play. Where the young children can understand what we're saying. Play. But with Sister Berlin, it was a revelation. That revelation went from dead to dying. That's the one.
That's the one. Yes.
Huh?
That's
the one. So when God comes down, he got to know it. They are the ones. That's the one. Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah.
Seven church ages, page 88.
Everybody listen.
The fervent desire to please God.
Hold on. Oh, Lord.
We pray. We pray. Vows. There's a portion of the bride vow. If you read, say. The Lord's what?
Bless the Lord. Bless
him,
Lord.
The fervent desire to please God. The passion to know his word.
Say that again.
The passion.
It's a passion, Brother John. We got to have a passion.
Yes,
right. I said we got to have a passion. The new word.
Brother Ben, you know what I'm talking about?
You know how we studied. Huh? We studied and we studied. There was a passion. Huh? And that passion, that hunger, that thirst is to know his will. Amen. Praise God.
The passion to know his word. The cry. From reaching out in the spirit, all begins to fade.
Why?
And instead of that church being on fire with the fire of God, it has cooled off.
Cool off.
And become a brick farm.
My God.
That is what happened back there to the Ephesians. They were getting a brick farm. The abandonment to God was dying out. And the people weren't too careful about what God thought of them. And they began to be careful about the world, what the world thought of them.
All right.
The second generation was just like Israel. They demanded a king to be like the other nations. When they did that, they rejected God. But they did it anyway. That is the history of the church. When it thinks more of conforming to the world instead of conforming to God, it isn't long until you see them stop doing things they used to do and start doing things they wouldn't do initially.
All right.
They change their manner of dress.
Go ahead, brother. Listen to here. What I'm saying here, even though the bride doesn't make herself ready, here. The thing that the world is creeping right back in the church.
I've
been told it's creeping right back in. I ain't talking about the denomination, I'm talking about the message. The message church, if God don't come, I can see what he said now. It's only going to be a few, but you just have to mind how you meant that, though. There's a revelation about that. Go ahead, brother.
They change their manner of dress, their attitudes, and their behavior. They get lax. That is That is what Ephesus means. Relax. Drifting.
Drifting. Y'all, if I know what that is.
Mm-hmm.
But listen, man, but not the bride.
Why?
The bride don't drift.
No.
The bride gets away and pray.
Amen.
The bride remember her marriage vows. The bride know that there was going to be some hard time. Everybody know there's going to be some hard time. When you come to this mess, we didn't come to flop and in. We know it's going to be a hard time. We know it's going to be some ups and downs. But God had already equipped you and I. But God preached a message when God called man, he equipped that man. Amen. He equipped it, fully equipped him. When God called y'all in this mess, let me tell you something, brothers and sisters, in closing. God equipped you. He equipped you for every battle, every trial, everything that you've been in front of. God equips you for it.
That cycle of revival and death has never failed. All you have to do is recall this last move of God in the Spirit. When men and women dress like Christians, went to church, praying all night, took the street corners, and weren't ashamed of the manifestations of the Spirit.
It's been a great thing and all. You don't see that anymore. Every now and then you probably see somebody burning up like that. But now it has been a great cooling off. We got so much revelation. We got so much this and that. Until we just don't have that desire to do those things anymore, brothers and sisters. And that is a shame of Almighty God. And you, look, what if you do? Pray to God, send somebody, or you pray to them, you can wait with somebody. Tell somebody.
Notice this character. When you see women just go on the rampage, just doing anything they want to do, watch. The church is doing the same thing.
Right.
Notice. But watch when the spiritual bride, when she begins to have a revival, when she begins to come back and line herself up with the Word of God.
Come back and line herself up with the Word of God.
Watch then again, you see, how that the scriptures, at that time, there'll be a message sweep out to catch that bride, catch that woman, elect.
She had made herself ready. The bride had made herself ready.
She is him. The word will be great in the bride.
Did he say? Did he say?
Yes.
Did he say?
Yes, he did.
Did he say?
Yes.
He said the word will be great in the what?
Bride.
The word, not your flesh. Take your eyes off your flesh and put it on the word.
Yes.
He said the word, that's what he said. He said the word will be great in the bride.
The bride is likened unto pure gold.
The bride, she is likened unto pure gold.
So thank you, Lord.
Now, the balance of your day, be good to yourself and thank you not when God has made you
something.
Amen. The bride shares a joint heir relationship.
Good God.
Bride.
The bride has a joint heir.
A joint heir relationship. The bride has chosen, was chosen before the word began.
Right. Oh my God, heaven.
Right.
Hold on.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, yes.
He said that the bride was chosen before the bride.
Will speak the same things as the Spirit.
My God.
The bride has his very image.
Very
image.
Amen.
The bride has the mind of Christ.
Yes.
Glory.
The bride has thus saith the Lord.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's what make everybody stand on the feet.
Yes, sir.
The bride has thus saith the Lord.
The bride
right.
Has thus saith the Lord. The Lord speaks to his bride. Bride and groom have become one.
Amen.
Yes.
Right.
Go ahead, bro.
The bride is the manifestation of the hour.
Yeah. things with green fields and things. He said that pride is his temple. So when the devil get on, listen to me. He can't get in your soul, but when the devil get on your flesh with temples, so hold up, that's not the character of my husband. Yourself, but they gotta be talking without me praying. Some people asked me yesterday, who you talking to? I said, you only knew. When our body started having temper fits, oh, wait a minute, just say it right here. You know what this, I'm acting unseemly now. And the reason why, Brother Trey, I'm acting unseemly because of this spirit that's around. Devils are hobo spirits. They took on one, get on the other. Jump on God and get on this man here. And then sometimes ain't nothing you got to do.
Nothing.
He probably see you probably ain't read a scripture in about a couple of weeks. He already know you weak as I am.
A couple weeks.
He probably know that you ain't gonna take in about a month. He already know that you weak as I will. So look at him, that was an easy prayer right there.
Right.
Say, how you know? Because I can sit in church and tell they weak.
All right. Brother and sister, you need to find out who you really are. Once you find out who you really are, you start thinking different.
Yes,
sir. Finish reading up, we got to go.
Bless it, Lord.
The pride is the pillars in the temple.
Did you hear what he just said? I'm trying to go. He said that the bride is the pillar of the temple. But it ain't gonna be water this time, but it's gonna be fire.
you know, he got crazy a little bit. Different names. Yeah.
And the girl said, hey, look.
Thank you, Lord.
The ministry where manifest word pride. The bride will sit in the throne with him. Bride, prophet, and spirit speaks the same.
Yes.
He walks in the midst of his bride. Mighty works will be found in the bride. The bride is the final voice of the message. The bride gives God a voice. The bride gives God a voice.
You got to use somebody.
She is the city of God. She is the word of God. She is the good seed.
Give me strength.
Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Grant it, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
How many love the Lord? I don't know what I'd do, but I wouldn't want to be in this world. I heard somebody say, no, oh, man, I'm brand new world now. And all things have passed away. Lord, all things are new. Ever since the happy day. Glory to God. We've just been having some good preaching. The Lord bless all of you. Let's remember Brother Mike and be back to Columbia. He's preaching at Brother Anderson. Probably it's over with now, finished over with. And pray God give us safer ride. Amen. Back home. We just love the Lord and just keep praying. You give yourself every day. And say to God to bring some more souls in. We our voice can't get them, the voice of God can speak to them. Yeah. Remember we went up on yesterday, called, me and Brother Hammond met the contractor up there yesterday and just prayed that his weather healed and we're going to start in about a week or something over there. So let's remember that. And what day is this? No, when is it?
In March, last March. Last of March.
Now, we might have a little meeting over there. We'll never know, though. But we got a lot of work today. He said he could hang the sheep around and bring in one day to see it. And so, I'll never know. We just appreciate the Lord, all things and everything. Let's be a witness.
Yes,
wherever you are, wherever your path may lead, be a witness. Be a true born-again witness. Sister Lewis, I think that they made some good songs there today. So God is good and we appreciate you. Go home and take the name of Jesus with you. Trial, sorrow, and the war. This is the medicine.
Amen.
Take
it. Amen.
It'll come supernatural. I rose up with more strength this morning. And I ain't had to do nothing. The Duke gave it to me. But he gave it. It's all well. It's all is well.
Lord God, we thank you for another opportunity.
Hallelujah.
Stand in our presence.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord God, for you telling us of your love for us, giving us strength and courage and wisdom and understanding to develop prudency in our lives, Lord God, that we can live above the ways of Laodicea. Lord, we just thank you once again for the ministry here, and we just pray, Lord God, that will keep lifting us up, Lord God. Keep shining thy light upon thy word, Lord God, and giving more power to the seed that you have placed inside of each of us, Lord God. That we who withdraw will not remain without hidden those that sleep, but that we'll be caught up to meet thee in the air, Lord God. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, Lord Jesus, may it dwell with each of us, henceforth, now, and forevermore. Church say, Amen. Amen.